Hi friends, welcome to our YouTube channel Naraj Academy. The main aim of this lecture is to discuss about the SAT prelims of 2021 of general studies in a very very detailed manner. And if you like the content of our channel, then please do like, share and subscribe our YouTube channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon button so whenever you upload a new video, the direct notifications comes from mobile. If any improvements here in our lectures, then please do comment in the comment section. We will definitely include all those improvements in the coming lectures. So why to waste more time? So let's get started. So now we are going to solve the 11th question. See the question here. The sum of the series 2 square plus 4 square plus 6 square up to 20 square we need to figure out. So what are the four options? Option B, 1540 is the correct solution of this question. So let's solve this numerical. So in this question they asked what is the 2 square plus 4 square plus 6 square up to 20 square. So before I solve this numerical, let me tell you some of the important formulas. See, 1 plus 2 plus up to n is equal to sum of n consecutive integers is equal to n into n plus 1 by 2. But if you do the 1 square plus 2 square up to n square, then it is n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 by 6. But if you take the cube, 1 cube plus 2 cube up to n cube, then the total summation is n into n plus 1 by 2 whole square. So these are the very very important formulas. So now we will solve this numerical. See carefully here, I can write 2 is nothing but 2 into 1 whole square, and 4 as 2 into 2 whole square, and similarly 6 2 into 3 again square up to 2 into 10 whole square. So in the, if you see carefully from all these terms, each individually I am going to split here. So 2 square into 1 square, and again 2 square into 2 square, this is 2 square into 3 square up to 2 square into 10 square, which is a into b onto the power of m is equal to a to the power of m into b to the power of m. So by this formula I have divided this one. So now if you see carefully from all these terms, 2 square is the common term, so therefore I am going to take 2 square as the common terms, and the remaining thing is 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square up to 10 square. So 2 square is now 4. So if you see carefully, this 1 square plus 2 square up to n square, so this is the formula we have to use. N into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 by 6. Here n is nothing but 10. So therefore in place of n, substitute here. So 10 into 11 into this one. 10 into 11 into 21 by 6. The by using that formula, and this is 4. So if you solve this one, we are going to get 1540. So therefore 2 square plus 4 square plus 6 square up to 20 square is nothing but here 1540 is the correct solution of this question. So among these three formulas, we have used the second formula in order to solve this numerical. So now I am going to solve the 12th question. See the question here. If a cross b means a square plus b square, then the value of the 5 cross of 4 cross 3 we need to figure out. So what are the four options? Option C, 650 is the correct solution of this question. So let's solve this numerical. So basically in this question, a cross b means a square plus b square. So in this question they are asking what is the value of the 5 cross of 4 cross 3 we need to figure out. So I am going to apply this formula for this first term, which is 4 cross 3, which is 4 square plus 3 square. So 4 square plus 3 square is nothing but 4 square is 16 plus 9, which is 25. So therefore 5 cross of 25. And for this again I am going to apply the same formula. So therefore here 5 square plus 25 square. So 5 square is 25 and 25 square is 625. 25 plus 625 is 650. So therefore 650 is the correct solution of this question. So now we are going to solve the 13th question. See the question here. So what is the angle between the hour hand and the minute hand of a clock at 3:30? So we need to find what is the angle between the hour hand and the minute hand at the 3:30. So what are the four options? Option C, 75 degree is the correct solution of this question. So let's solve this numerical. So basically the speed of a hour hand is equal to the speed of the hour hand is equal to half degree in 1 minute. So for every 1 minute the hour hand is going to rotate by an angle of half degree, and similarly the speed of the minute hand is equal to 6 degree in 1 minute. Means for every 1 minute the minute hand is going to make an angle by 6 degree. So here in this question they are asking what is the angle between the hour hand and the minute hand at the time of 3:30. So therefore here, for now I am going to calculate what is the angle for the hour hand, how much of angle which is covered by the hour hand. So therefore for the hour hand, the total number of minutes I need to figure out. So 3 hours. So 3 hours means for 1 hour 60 minutes. So for 3 hours, 3 into 60 minutes, and there is also an extra 30 minutes, so plus 30. So this much amount of minutes are going to covered by the hour hand. So for every 1 minute there is an angle of half degree. So therefore this much number of minutes now I need to multiply by half degree. So therefore finally this total summation will become 210 by 2. So therefore if you do the division, we are going to get 105 degree. So therefore 105 degree of angle is covered by the hour hand. So therefore this black is nothing but this is a hour hand. So this is going to make with respect to this vertical line at an angle of 105 degree. So this total angle is now 105 degree only for the hour hand. So now I want to know for the minute hand how much amount of angle is covered. So the minute is only 30 minutes. So for 30 minutes means for 1 minute 60 degree rotation. So for 30 minutes 30 into 6 degree. So 30 into 6 is nothing but 180 degree. So therefore the minute hand is going to make an angle of, so this total angle is now 180 degree. So now I want to know what is the angle between this hour hand and the minute hand. So therefore total is 180 and this one is 105. So therefore 190 minus 105, this is the angle between the hour hand and the minute hand. So this is the angle theta. So therefore theta is equal to 180 total angle minus 105. So theta is equal to 180 minus 105, it is nothing but 75 degree. So 75 degree is the angle between the hour hand and the minute hand. Or you can do it in another fashion also, direct by using the formula also, which is suppose hour into minute. So hour and minute, which is nothing but 3 into 30 here in this case. So the general formula is theta is equal to always the modulus, means the positive value we need to take, 30h minus 11 by 2 m. So here in this case h is nothing but 3 and m is 30. So therefore substitute here in place of h 3 and in place of m 30. So if you solve this one, 30 into 3 is 90, 11 by 2 into 30 is nothing but 165. So you have to take the positive value, which is theta is equal to 75 degree. Either you can do in this process or either you can do it in that by using the remembering the formula also you can do it. So anyhow the answer is the 75 degree. So now I am going to solve the 14th question. See the question here. A is twice as good a workman as B. So A is twice as good as workman B, and together they can finish a piece of work in 18 days. So there is some work. So this work can be finished by this both A and B in 18 days. So in how many days will A alone can finish the work? So we need to find in how many days A alone is sufficient to complete this work. So how many days we need to figure out. So out of the four options, option C, 27 days is the correct solution of this question. So let's solve this numerical. So now I am going to assume the total work is nothing but 180 units. So I am going to assume the total work is 180 units in this case. So you can take any number, but for easiness I am going to use here 180 units. So here in this question they also told that the person A is twice efficient as the person B, means he is twice more goodness than the person B. Suppose the person B is going to do 8 means x units in one day. Suppose the rate of person B is nothing but x units of work he can do in one day. So in the question they also given that here the person A is twice the efficient, means if person A is going to do x units in one day, so therefore the person A will do 2x units in one day. So therefore the rate of A is equal to 2x units, means the person A can do complete 2x units work in one day, and similarly the person B can complete x units in one day. So therefore now in the question they also told that if these two persons are working together, then they can complete this work in 18 days. So therefore one day, if you want to know what is in one day total units covered by these two persons, is 2x plus x. But they also told that in 18 days, so therefore you have to do for the 18 days in order to complete the 180 units of work. So 2x plus x is 3x into 18 is equal to 180. So I want to know what is the value of the x. X is equal to 180 by 3 into 18. So in order to easiness only, I have taken the total number of unit work is 180. So therefore by easiness, so one, this is 10. So therefore 10 by 3 units. So therefore x is equal to 10 by 3. So therefore the rate of A is equal to 2x. So in place of x substitute 10 by 3, then we are going to get 20 by 3. So therefore the person A can complete only 20 by 3 units in one day. So therefore 20 by 3 units in one day, I want to calculate how much the total work is 180 units, in how many days he can complete. Let me assume this is a P days. So therefore do the division to 20 by 3 by 180 is equal to 1 by P. So from this there is only one unknown P. If you solve this, we are going to get P is equal to 27 days. So therefore the person A can complete his total work in 180 units in 27 days. So therefore the person A alone can complete the total work of 180 units in 27 days. So now we are going to solve the 15th question. See the question here. If 2x plus 3y is to 3x plus 5y is equal to 18 is to 29, then what is the value of the x is to y? So what are the four options? Option C, 3 is to 4 is the correct solution of this question. So let's solve this numerical. So in the question they are given that 2x plus 3y by 3x plus 5y is equal to 18 by 29. So we have to find what is the value of the x by y we need to find, the ratio. So now I am going to the cross multiplication, which is 29 into 2x plus 3y is equal to 18 into 3x plus 5y. So 29 into 2 is nothing but 58x. And similarly, 29 into 3y is equal to 87y. And similarly, 18 into 3x is 54x. And similarly, 18 into 5y is 90y. So therefore, now I am going to take here this x to this side. So 58 minus 54x is equal to 4x. And this 87y, I am going to move it to the right side. So therefore, 90y minus 87y is equal to 3y. So x by y is equal to 3 by 4. So therefore, the ratio of the x by y is equal to 3 by 4. So 3 by 4 is the correct solution of this question. So now we are going to solve the 16th question. See the question here. In how many years will a sum of rupees 800 at 10% per annum compounded semi-annually becomes rupees 926.10? So in the question, they are given a initial sum of 800 rupees and the rate per annum is per year, the rate is 10%, and we are going to do the semi-compounded, means we are going to for every half year, means for every 6 months we are going to the compound. So therefore here, in how many years the total summation will become 926.10 rupees. So out of the four options, option B is the correct solution of this question, 1.5 year. So let's solve this numerical. So now I am going to write the first formula is for the compound interest formula, which is A is equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 whole to the power of T. This is for the 1 year. But if you want to know if right. This formula for the same year means, see, for 1 year is nothing but total 12 months. So therefore, if you do divide by 2, so therefore 6 months. So therefore here, we have to divide by 2. Same year means 6 months. So therefore, you have to divide by 2. So in place of R, replace R by 2 and replace T by 2T. But if you want to write the same formula for the quarter year, so quarter year means total 12 months by 4, which is nothing but here 3 months. So 1 quarter is nothing but 3 months. So therefore now replace R by 4 and replace T by 4T. So this is the formulas we have to do some modifications for the main formula. So therefore now in the question they are given a semi year. So we are going to use this formula. So therefore A is equal to P into 1 plus R by 2 by 100 over the power of 2T. So the total amount, so the principal amount is 800. So after some time, the amount has become 926.10 rupees with an interest of R is equal to 10%. So, and what is the time we have to figure out for semi-annually? Semi-annually means 6 months. For every 6 months, we are going to do the compounded. So therefore, A is equal to P into 1 plus R by 2 whole to the power of, by 100 whole to the power of 2T. So A is equal to 926.10 and P is equal to 800. 1 plus R is 10. 10 by 2 by 100 whole to the power of 2T. So 10 by 2 is nothing but 5. So therefore, 5 by 100 will become now 0.05. So 1 plus 0.05 now will become 1.05. So therefore now I am going to take this 800 downwards. Now 926.10 by 800 is equal to 1.05 whole to the power of 2t. So this whole thing now will become 1.158 is equal to 1.05 whole to the power of 2t. So now I am going to take a log with a base of 1.05. 1.158 is equal to 2t. So this whole thing is now we are going to get nearly 3. So therefore 2t is nearly equal to 3. So t nearly equal to 3 by 2, which is 1.5 year. So with the year of means in the period of 1.5 year, which is nothing but 1 half year, we are going to get a from principal amount of 800 rupees to 926.10 at a rate of 10% when we are doing the component for every same year, means for only for every 6 months we are going to do the component. So in this manner we are going to get, so the correct answer is 1.5 year. So now we are going to solve the 17th question. See the question here. If x plus 1 by x minus 1 is equal to a by b and 1 minus y by 1 plus y is equal to b by a, then what is the value of the x minus y by 1 plus xy? So here, out of the four options, option A, 2ab by a square minus b square is the correct solution of this question. So let's solve this numerical. In the question, they are given that x plus 1 by x minus 1 is equal to a by b and 1 minus y by 1 plus y is equal to b by a. And now I need to find what is the x minus y by 1 plus xy we need to figure out. So these are the four options. So basically, I want to do this numerical in a very, within a small number of steps. So what I am going to do is here, I am going to assume that a is equal to 1 and b is equal to 2. So these are the small values I am going to consider and I am going to substitute there. So therefore, x plus 1 by x minus 1 is equal to a by b. So a is 1 and b is 2. So now if I solve this one, which is now I am going to do the cross multiplication, just 2x plus 2 is equal to x minus 1. So if I solve this one, I am going to get x is equal to minus 3. And similarly here also, 1 minus 1 by 1 plus y is equal to b by a. So b is 2 and a is 1. So 2 by 1. And now I am going to do the cross multiplication. Finally, I am going to get 1 minus y is equal to 2 plus 2y. So finally, I am going to solving. After that, I am going to get y is equal to minus 1 by 3. So I got the value of the x and also I got the value of the y. I am going to substitute in the here. X minus y by 1 plus xy. So x is equal to minus 3 and y is equal to minus 1 by 3. If you substitute and if you solve, finally we are going to get minus 4 by 3. So therefore this total is going to give you a value of minus 4 by 3. So out of the four options, now I need to check which option is going to give you the result of the minus 4 by 3. So now I am going to take the option A, which is 2ab by a square minus b square. So I know the value of a and also I know the value of b. So a is equal to 1 and b is equal to 2. If you substitute there, finally we are going to get minus 4 by 3. So therefore we can conclude that, so here only this option A is going to satisfy and remaining all other options are not going to give you a value of minus 4 by 3. So therefore the remaining options are wrong. Only option A is a correct solution. So therefore we can conclude that x minus y by 1 plus xy is equal to 2ab by a square minus b square. So by assuming some values of a and b, so we can solve this numeric in a less number of steps. So now we are going to solve the 18th question. See the question here. The value of sigma up to 1 to n 1 by x plus 3 into x plus 4 is. So out of the four options, option C is the correct solution. Means here the total summation will now converge to which value. So out of the four options, option C is the correct solution of this question. So let's solve this numerical. So now we need to find what is the summation from x is equal to 1 to x is equal to n. So this total summation will converge to which value out of these four options we need to check. So here we are going to do some by small substitution here. Suppose now I am going to take only the first two terms. Let I am going to assume only the first two terms. See here x is equal to 1 and x is equal to 2. Only these two terms are going to I am going to consider and I am going to do the sum and then I am going to check in the options. So which one is going to satisfy that? That is the correct solution. So here now I am going to take only the first two terms. So therefore here when x is equal to 1, so if you substitute here x is equal to 1, so 1 plus 3 is 4 and 1 plus 4 is 5. So therefore 1 by 4 into 5. And when I am going to substitute x is equal to 2, so 2 plus 3 is 5 and 2 plus 4 is 6. So therefore 1 by 5 into 6. So out of this 1 by 5 is a common. So 1 by 5 I am going to take it as common. So 1 by 4 plus 1 by 6 and 4 and 6 LCM is 12. So 4 3 is a 6 2 is a. So 3 plus 2 is nothing but 5. So therefore this is 5 and this is also 5. So 5 5 get cancelled. So therefore 1 by 12. So if I take the first two terms, then the summation is going to result to 1 by 12. So now I am going to check in the options which one is going to give the same result. So therefore option A, which is n by n plus 2. So if I substitute n is equal to 2, I am going to get 2 by 5. And option B is 2n by n plus 1. If I substitute n is equal to 2, I am going to get 4 by 3. And option C is n by 4 into n plus 4. So therefore if I substitute n is equal to 2, I am going to get 1 by 12. Yes, this is going to satisfy. So therefore C is the correct solution. And let me check D also, which is n by 2 into n plus 2. If I substitute n is equal to 2, I am going to get 1 by 4. So therefore only option C is going to give the result of 1 by 12 as we have taken the first two terms. So first two terms are going to, if you do the summation, I am going to get 1 by 12. And this formula is also going to give the same thing, 1 by 12. So therefore option C is the correct solution of this question. So now I am going to solve the 19th question. See the question here. Statement 1, A has more coins than B. Statement 2, B has fewer coins than C. And statement 3, C has fewer coins than A. If the statement 1 is true and the statement 2 is false, then the statement 3 is. So in the question they are given three statements and they are also given that statement 1 is correct and also the statement 2 is wrong. Then what is about the statement 3? We have to conclude based on the 1 and 2 statements. So what are the four options? Option A. So statement 3 is always correct. So therefore let's solve this numerical. So in the question they are given that the first statement is the person A has more coins than B. So I am going to take here A is greater than B, means the person A is going to have more number of coins when compared to person B. So A is greater than B. And second statement they are also given that here the person B has lesser coins than person C. So I can write it another fashion, which is the person C has more number of coins than person B. So in the statement 3, they have given that the person C has less number of coins than person A. So again, write in another fashion, which is the person A will have more number of coins than C. So if C less than A means, we can write in another fashion, which is A greater than C. So in the question, they have given that if the statement 1 is correct and the statement 2 is wrong, then I need to know, I need to check. So what is the statement C? Whether it is correct or not, we need to check. So therefore here, if you see carefully, the first statement is correct. So therefore, same thing I am going to write, A greater than B. And they have told that the statement 2 is false, means B less than C is wrong. See, B less than C, if it is wrong, the right one will become now B greater than C, simply. So therefore here, so this is the correct statement now. So this is also first statement and this is the second statement. So therefore, if the statement is wrong, means the right will be, suppose B less than C is wrong, so therefore the right statement will be B greater than C. So therefore here, from these two we can check, so from these two statements, A greater than B and B greater than C. So therefore we can conclude that A greater than B, B greater than C. So therefore this is the conclusion. So from this conclusion, we need to check what is about this statement C. In the question they are given that here the statement C is A greater than C, yes. So from the conclusion also we got the same thing, A is greater than C. So we can conclude that this statement is also right. So based on the statement 1 and statement 2, we have concluded that the statement 3 is always correct. So now we are going to solve the last question of this lecture. See the question here. If x is equal to u into v and y is equal to u plus v by u minus v, then what is the value of the du of u comma v by du of x comma y? We need to figure out. So what are the four options? Option A is the correct solution of this question, which is u minus v whole square by 4uv is the correct solution of this question. So let's solve this numerical. So in this question they are given that x is equal to u into v and y is equal to u plus v by u minus v. So I need to find what is the value of the dou u comma v by dou x comma y. I need to figure out. So here dou u comma v by dou x comma y, I can write in another fashion, means reciprocal, means 1 by dou x comma y by dou u comma v. So just I've written this one downward. So therefore this is the thing we have got. So here the formula of this one, so I know the formula of this one. So this is nothing but here dou x comma y by dou u comma v. So dou x comma y by dou u comma v is nothing but here. So this is x and y. So you have to write here x, this is y. So u comma v means u comma v. So this total is nothing but it is a modulus, or it is nothing but it is a modulus of this one, means determinant. So modulus means this is the determinant. So here dou x by dou u, dou x by dou v, so dou y by dou u and dou y by dou v. So these values we need to figure out, and then we have to take the determinant of that one. Then this is nothing but this whole thing is now becomes this one. So therefore here first we have to do the derivative. So dou x by dou u we need to figure out. See, x is equal to u into v, so dou x by dou u is nothing but here v. So the remaining v will become constant, so therefore it will become v. So dou x by dou v, if you do the derivative with respect to y, so v, then u will become constant, so it is nothing but here u. And similarly dou y by dou u, so y is equal to u plus v by u minus v. If you do the derivative, which is u derivative, means this is y is equal to u plus v by u minus v. So if you do the derivative with respect to u, so therefore here first you have to do the derivative, this one it will become 1, as then u minus v minus of u plus v into this one will become 1. So by u minus v whole square, which is nothing but general here derivative of u by v is equal to u derivative v minus u v derivative by v square. So by using this formula I have did this one. So finally I am going to get minus 2v by u minus v whole square. And similarly dou y by dou v, so now u will become constant, then you have to do the derivative of this one. So finally this is the thing I am going to get. So final solution is 2u by u minus v whole square. So I know the value of each and individual, so now I am going to substitute all the values which I have got in this one. So therefore dou x comma y by dou u comma v is nothing but this is v, this is u, minus 2v by u minus v whole square, 2u by v minus v whole square. Now I need to find what is the determinant. So therefore do cross multiplication minus of this one. So this cross multiplication will become 2uv by v minus v whole square minus of this cross multiplication. I am going to get 2uv by u minus v whole square. So both are same. If we add, finally I am going to get 4uv by u minus v whole square. See, this is dou x comma y by dou u comma v, but I need the value of the dou u comma v by dou x comma y, means I need to do the in reciprocal. So therefore dou u comma v by dou x comma y is equal to just this denominator will go upper and the upper will become downer. So therefore u minus v whole square by 4ub. So therefore this is the correct, this is the thing in which we need. So therefore this is the correct solution of this question, which is dou u comma v by dou x comma y is equal to u minus v whole square by 4ub. Actually by this formula we have got the dou x comma y by dou u comma v, but we need the reciprocal. So therefore just whatever the solution we got, just we have to do the reciprocal, then we are going to get the actual solution of this question. So by this lecture we have successfully completed the DSC prelims of 2021 of general studies in a very very detailed manner. And if you like the content of our channel, then please do like, share and subscribe our YouTube channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon button so whenever we upload a new video the direct notifications comes through mobile. If any improvements needed in our video lectures, then please do comment in the comment section. We will definitely include all those improvements in the coming lectures. So why to waste more time? So let's get started.